To the Rakahama band and mamas. In our own Rangatidama, Tenako Cho, Katoa, and welcome everybody. All these very famous, wonderful faces in front of us, Marama.
I know, I'm quite bedazzled, but that's not just the faces out there. It's rather your outfit, you know. Even you're protecting your own eyes, the IC.
No, it's just that I was going to tone it down, the same. So it gives you the up. You see, you've got the colour, you see.
Well, it is us again. We're very sorry. It's the two random. So we're back again. But I tell you, we love tonight. Tonight is such a celebration. Everyone here, we're all family. And I'm so excited. The winners, especially, the 38 million.
Oh, God. Well, actually, I did promise I was going to have a sort of a little spiel to the politicians here. But, you know, the fact that this is a wonderful Pacific Arts strategy, and really thanks to all the Arts Council, and also to the Stephen, I have seen you, Stephen Wainwright, the CEO, who really, really let this run, isn't
it? Okay, enough greasing now. We just want to introduce I'm Marama, and also the fabulous. Well, we'd just also like to acknowledge everyone who is here tonight. First of all, thank you for having us, and your Ale, Associate Minister for Arts, Kamau Sepuloni. Thank you for having us and hosting tonight. If everyone can put their hands together. The party is on, Kamau. Also, I know that Aupito William Seal will be here joining us again later, the Minister for Pacific Peoples. And also, I'd like to acknowledge our other Pacific MPs as well, Anahila, Kano Ngā Ta'a, Sui Suiki, Jenny Salisa. I'm trying
Jenny
to look around. This year's Jenny. And also, we want to acknowledge the support as well. Opposition spokesperson for the arts, Nikki Wagner, and of course, all of our MPs, and we can't forget as well other members of parliament, Pacific artists, of course, who we're here to celebrate tonight, our community leaders, and also the key CNZ stakeholders, including investment clients and partners.
You know, Marama, this time we need to sort of remind people that this is parliament, and now and again you've got those bell things ringing. And, so just to say that it does happen here because this is Parliament. And but don't run away because it's part and parcel of it. But also to remind people that this is going live on Facebook.
Oh, yes. That's right. So is there a hashtag as well if you're taking any photos of us? Is there a CNZ Arts Awards hashtag? Just wondering. I know Hangry Jasmine, where is she? She'll tell us. Arts Pacifica Awards. So if you can hashtag us, here we go. Thank you. Okay then. And we can't start our night, of course, without a health and safety notice. Apparently we were really boring last year, so they've got someone else to do it. Here we go.
They've got a younger version to do it.
Kia ora. Welcome to Air New Zealand. In case of any emergencies.
Not in New Zealand, Creative New Zealand.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sorry, I've got something prepared. Welcome to the Arts Pacifica Awards. I've got some safety tips if you're rushing out the door. In the event of an emergency, there's nothing we can't handle. Lift your lover, and don't trip over your jandal. If for any reason the alarms do sound, leave how you entered or exit near yourself. Follow the directions of the wardens or security. Assemble on the front lawn, avoid the infirmary. Maybe take a stop at the chocolate fondue. Take one, take two, nah, always take a few. In the event of a quake, drop cover, then hold. Don't try to leave if the ground's on a roll. Stay inside the venue, take instruction from the staff. That's the safety wrap, now let's celebrate the arts.
Give it up for Prabhupada. All I heard was chocolate fondue. Where's the chocolate fondue?
Outside. Oh, okay. And it's finished.
Okay, then. Well,
okay, I think we better start, hey?
I think we better. Okay, then.
Okay, I'm going to introduce the wonderful Karen Rangi, to come up here on stage. Karen Rangi, of course, is the deputy chair of the Arts Council. Let's give her a big warm up from people.
Tau mai nā runga te matai te pōra. Maringi te pūre. Maringi te pūre. It's my pleasure on behalf of my colleagues on the Arts Council, especially Dame Lua Manawa Winnie Laban, my colleagues here, Wayne Marriott, Roger King, Dean Whiting, to not only welcome you all here tonight to the biggest Pacific party in town, but it's also my pleasure to introduce our chairman of the Arts Council, Michael Moynihan. Please give him a hand.
Thank you, Karen. Whakalofa lahi atu, tolofa lava, and warm Pacific greetings. I bring you the warmest welcome on behalf of the Arts Council of New Zealand as we celebrate tonight Excellence in Pacific Arts for 2019. I want to welcome again all of the dignitaries who are here this evening, and most of all, a welcome to the talented award winners, whānau and friends of the arts. This is our second time in the Banquet Hall at Parliament, and I'd like to thank our host for the evening, Associate Minister for the Arts, the Honourable Carmel Cipollone. In actual fact, there are a number of other people, ministers and members of Parliament who are here tonight. Rather than rename you, I want to actually say to you, your presence here is extraordinarily important. The capacity that you show by being here and being prepared to support the art and the impact that it has on Aotearoa is significant. So thank you so much for your presence this evening. Your Excellencies and Ambassadors, artists and arts community, thank you for the support. Thank you for your presence. It's been an exciting year. Just over a year ago, we launched our first strategy for the Pacific Arts in the Grand Hall to develop aimed at developing a powerful sector led by passionate and skilled Pacifica people for Aotearoa, Te Moana, Nui Akiwa, and actually for the world. I'm extremely proud of the work that Creative New Zealand continues to do as we implement our Pacific Arts strategy. And in the last year, we've been able to achieve a great number of initiatives, and the Minister will allude to some of these in a moment. Since the last Pacifica Awards, the Arts Council has also launched a new Teha O Ngā Toi Māori Arts Strategy and an investment strategy across all of our funding programs. Together with the Pacific Strategy, these help to guide our waka towards a future where arts matter and where we celebrate creativity, innovation and diversity in our nation. I want to thank my Arts Council colleagues, and in particular, Lua Manawao, Dame Winnie Laban, and the Deputy Chair, Karen Rangi, who bring a powerful voice for Pacific Arts to the conversations we have. There's a lot of exciting achievements in Pacific arts, and Creative New Zealand is proud to play a part in their stories and to continue to work together to support bold and dynamic Pacific arts for the benefit of all New Zealanders and our country. I'm thrilled to be here this evening as we celebrate 8 fabulous Pacifica artists in 7 award categories, and I want to thank you for joining us as we honour the recipients of the 2019 Pacifica Awards. Thank you. It is my enormously great pleasure to welcome to the stage Minister, Associate Minister for Arts, Carmel Cipollone.
Whakalofalahi atu kia mutolu osi, and Happy Niuean Language Week to all of you here tonight. Welcome to you all. Can I just say it is such a privilege for me to be able to host you all here again in this Parliament, in your Parliament, as the Associate Minister for Arts, Culture and Heritage. On becoming Minister in this government, I knew the only way that I was going to be able to continue to keep up with the amazing work of so many people that I respect and so many friends that I have is by securing a role with the Arts, Culture and Heritage portfolio. So I want to say whakauelahi to our Minister and our Minister of Arts, Culture and Heritage, the Honourable Jacinda Ardern, for granting me that request. This is a room full of amazing people, and although I don't have time to mention each and every one of you by name, I do want to make a few important acknowledgements. I'd like to begin by welcoming all my parliamentary colleagues. I think it's really essential that we have cross-parliament support for the Pacific, for our Pacific people, and for our arts. So it is wonderful to see here tonight, and if they're not here, that's because they'll be coming at a later stage. But the Honourable Nanaia Mahuta, the Honourable Jenny Salesa, the Honourable Aupito William Seal, the Honourable Willie Jackson, the Honourable Nikki Wagner, Harete Hipango, Anahila Kanunga Taha Suisuki, and Agnes Lukheni here in the banquet hall with us tonight. Are there any other MPs that I've missed out? Good. To our former parliamentary colleague and now member of the Arts Council, Lua Manuvao, Dame Winnie Laban, welcome. And to the Chair and Deputy Chair of the Arts Council, Michael Moynihan and Karen Rangi, it is always good to see you and to work alongside you. I acknowledge Creative New Zealand's Chief Executive, Stephen Wainwright, and Awards Director, the wonderful Makarita Urali. And Makarita, can I just acknowledge you and thank you and your team for pulling together, as Karen said, the biggest party in Wellington tonight. Excellencies and ambassadors, award winners, friends and family, artists and creative leaders, and everyone here tonight to acknowledge excellence and innovation in the arts and to celebrate our arts and artists. Welcome. It has been another big year for Pacific Arts, and many exciting new initiatives have been introduced since the implementation of Creative New Zealand's Pacific Arts Strategy for 2018 to 2023, which I had the privilege of officially launching here, right here, a year ago. Tonight, I'd like to touch on some of the really impressive achievements that have already come from the first year of the strategy's implementation. Relevant for this evening's winners, a new Pacific Tour Artist Award category. Yes, do a big cheer for that one. valued at $10,000, will be presented for the first time this evening. This award recognises a Pasifika artist with the lived experience of disability, reflecting the sector's call to support Pasifika artists living with disabilities and to support our very diverse communities. And with my Minister for Disabilities hat on, can I say that is awesome. Prize money for all the awards has also been increased from this year onwards. In 2020, a new Moana Nui a Kiwa fund will be offered to support Pasifika arts projects in Oceania, and a new Arts Pasifika Fellowship valued at $65,000 will also be offered to Pasifika artists. For the first time in Wellington, the Pacific Heritage Arts Whānau will be taking place, a national whānau where master artists will gather from around the country to build community capacity for heritage arts. As stated by Michael just before, support for leadership development of Pasifika artists has been given a boost with a new partnership with Leadership New Zealand. Creative New Zealand will offer a new artist residency in Fiji, themed around climate change, in partnership with the University of the South Pacific, with other new opportunities being developed in the Cook Islands and New Caledonia to strengthen connections with Oceania. For the Rainbow Arts community, a new Pasifika Nuanua artist residency is also in the works. A joint work program with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade is in progress as a new partnership under the strategy to support Pasifika artists engaging in Oceania arts globally. And a new think tank of Pasifika Māori artists has been created that strives to empower their voices in decision making. There has also been a 68% increase in funding, which will be in effect from 2020 for Pasifika-led arts organisations in Creative New Zealand's investments program, from going from 1.27 million to 2.31 million. This includes the doubling of annual funding for Pacific Arts Organisation Tautai to 800,000 per year for the next 6 years, and the almost doubling of funding for Heritage Arts Organisation Pacifica Mamas to almost $400,000 for another 3 years. Black Grace, the Conch and Pacific Dance continue to be supported, as well as Tawata Productions. It is so awesome to see this strategy come to fruition since its implementation, and I'm sure we all in this room look forward to the other initiatives that will undoubtedly arise from it. Apart from these new strategic outcomes, I also really want to congratulate the Arts Council on the selection of Yuki Kihara as New Zealand's representative at the 2021 Venice Biennale. Yuki Kihara, yes, let's clap for Yuki. Yuki will be the first Pasifika artist to represent New Zealand at Venice. And in literature, I want to acknowledge Sean Mallon and Sebastian Galliott's beautiful book, Te Tau, A History of Samoan Tattooing, which won the Illustrated Nonfiction Award at the New Zealand Ockham Book Awards. I did say it's been a good year. In 1976, the poet and novelist Albert Wendt wrote an essay about the rebirth of Pacific art. In it, he said, "This artistic renaissance is enriching our cultures further, reinforcing our identities, self-respect and pride. It is also acting as a unifying force in our region. These artists, through their work, are explaining us to ourselves and creating a new Oceania." End quote. As we can see this evening, our vibrant Pacific art sector has come a long way since 1976. Our arts have always been intrinsic to our existence, but what that looks like in 2019 and beyond is for us to collectively define. The sentiment behind Albert Wendt's words still ring true. I am immensely proud of Pacific arts and artists. Their distinctiveness is central to what makes New Zealand different from any other nation, and also connects us to our tangata whenua here and our Pacific neighbours. I'm also proud to be part of a government that recognises the value of the arts, probably best reflected in the fact that its very own Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern chose to take on the Minister for Arts, Culture and Heritage portfolio. I hope ably assisted by me and Minister Grant Robertson. I want to end by congratulating the Arts Council and Creative New Zealand staff for their very, very hard work. And of course, acknowledging the Pasifika artists and communities that enrich all our lives with moana creativity and innovation. Kia monuia le pō. Now let's begin the awards. Whakatailawa.
Thank you very much, Minister. Whakawelahi.
Yes, you do. And now we come, as the Minister said, we now officially start our Creative New Zealand Arts Pacific Awards 2019.
Our first award, it's a new award, $10,000. It's offered for the first time under the Pacific Arts Strategy. The Pacific Toa Artist Award recognises the outstanding contribution of a Pasifika artist with the lived experience of disability, all the way from the beautiful islands of Samoa and Wainui Mata. The winner of the Pacific Toa Artist Award 2019 is Pati Umanga.
Makarita allowed me 2.5 minutes for my speech. I timed myself. Ma malu pea ia le aitu o le aoa, ila pa ia mal ma malu o le nei pō. Fa fetaile fa ia ia le nei au auna vai vai. O lau tutalo, ia tō mai wanga manuia o le atua ia te outau uma. The Honourable Carmel Cipollone, members of Creative New Zealand and the Creative New Zealand Pacific Arts Council, distinguished guests, co-award winners, I'm truly honoured by this honour, or truly humbled by this honour. I would like to acknowledge the Pacific Music Award Trust who put forward my nomination, the presence of my family members, and also my long-time carer and support worker. Thank you to New Creative New Zealand for establishing this award for our community of disabled artists. There are many of us, and while I sit on this stage as one disabled artist representing many, to accept the inaugural tour award, it would be remiss of me not to make a heartfelt plea. For this, the tour award, I hope, will light the fuse that towards full inclusion of our Pasifika disabled artists in the arts, in our iconic events and festivals such as the Pasifika Festival in Auckland, the South Pacific Arts Festivals to connect with our disabled brothers and sisters in the Pacific Islands, and to one day hold our own Disabled Pacific Arts event. The arts for us are more than just a creative expression, especially for those who are non-verbal. It's a reflection of our stories of lived experience. It's our well-being, it's our healing, and it's our way to challenge attitude, stigma, and the stereotype we face each and every day. We need support and collaboration with our peers. We need resources and funding so that we lead and build our own artistic capability. Creative New Zealand, my hope is that this is the beginning of a long and fruitful relationship of collaborative opportunities with our disabled artists. Thank you so much for establishing this award. Special shout out to Rita O'Reilly and her team for the Pacific Arts Summit that ultimately led to this award. Whawhite lava, ia manuia tātou pō alofa atu.
Thank you, Minister. I'd now like to invite onto the stage for our next award presenting is Dean Whiting from the Arts Council, please. Our next award recognises an emerging artist with the prize money of $7,500. The winner of this category is a young woman of Samoan and Pākehā descent, who is a te tau artist and has been learning traditional Samoan tau methods from Samoan masters. The winner of the Emerging Pacific Artist Award 2019 is Taylor Waiau.
Te whātalo whātu i le awa ma le whaalwaro i lo auto pā ia ma le auto mā man. Tālofa lava. Good evening, everyone. What an honour it is to be here among all you beautiful people on this fairly typical Wellington evening. Words can't express how grateful I am to be the recipient of the Emerging Pacifica Artist Award. When I first used a tattoo machine, which was just down the road at Rogers Tattoo Art on Cuba Street, Wellington. never did I imagine that one day I would be in the Beehive receiving such a prestigious award. It's such an honour to be recognised in this way for the work that I've done and for the potential to develop my practice further. Whawhetai te le lava, Creative New Zealand and the panel that selected me for this honour. This award is not only a win for myself, but for our Pasifika Te Tau community. Te Tau is one of our oldest art forms, and yet there's only been one other Te Tau artist to receive one of these awards, the legend that is Steve Marching. And I've looked up to Steve's work for a long time, so to be following in his footsteps is a dream. It's truly a dream. So not only is our art form underrepresented, but as a female practitioner, I'm also a minority within our field. I'm thankful to all Te Tau artists and Te Whungata Te Tau that have supported me in this space, especially my mentor, Su'a Suluape Alaiva Apetelo. It can be daunting, it can be a really daunting space to operate in as a woman. But it is my hope that my practice and this recognition, events like this, will encourage more of our Pasifika women to take up Te Tau. Lastly, I'd like to acknowledge all the people that have encouraged and supported me on this journey. My parents, Diane and Fa'alia Vai'au, who I hope are watching on Facebook over in Australia. My siblings, my uncle who's here with me, my children, my inga, my sisterhood, my fellow tāmoko and Te Tau artists, my community, and everyone that entrusts me to mark their skin. This award honours and celebrates you all, and I hope that I continue to make you proud. Whawhitai lava.
Thank you very much. To introduce our next act, can I now ask Roger King from the Arts Council to introduce our next act? Thank you.
This is not an award. Tonight we have a guest performance by two young men who were introduced to the world of opera through a project called Prima Volta. It's a program, and a fantastic program, for high school students in Hawke's Bay. I know a little bit about that because that's where I now live. They are now second-year students at Victoria University's School of Music. LJ Crichton and Masunu Tuua, will sing in Italian, a duet from Mozart's Così fan tutti, with Rose Campbell, our inimitable creative New Zealanders, on the piano. Their voices are still developing, but one day they may be standing on the stage as future winners of our Arts Pacific Awards. Please put your hands together for LJ and Masunu.
You know, Marama, I could have sung like that if I stuck to it, but I didn't really. Because I didn't have the talent.
Well, we're going to hear about some more very talented singers very shortly. Just like to ask Arts Council Member Roger Kane to come back to the stage to present our next award, please. So our next award is named after the late opera singer Yosefa Enari, with a prize of $7,500. This year's winner is a rising star in the opera world, where Pasifika are really thriving. He was actually, like Fui Maono, a fantastic rugby player at college and thought about a professional career in rugby. But we're thrilled he swapped the rugby ball for a love of opera. And last week, he flew off to London to study opera at one of the world's most prestigious music schools. Tonight, his uncle, Heka Robertson, is here to accept his award, and his mum and younger brother are also here. The winner of the Yosefa Enari Memorial Award 2019 is Samson Settle. London, he has sent us a special video. Congratulations, Samson.
Yeah, congratulations. Gosh, you know, it's just amazing, isn't it? We're actually ahead of our time, I have to tell you. And now we had to do ad-lib because that Margarita didn't do anything else. So, first of all, hello, Dame Winnie Laban. All the other famous people I'd like to acknowledge, apart from all the artists and things. I can see Nathaniel Lees over there. Title fellow to you, Nathaniels.
I can see Victor Roger over there in his very smart hat. And I think I saw Vela Manosalte and Licky Burke. Yes. Some new Wayans in the house? Any new Wayans in the house? If you raise your hand, you have to come up on stage.
Yeah. Is Carla here? Carla was Carla from Otaki. Where's Carla? The famous Carla. Ah, there she is. Now, we thought we were going to be stranded today at Auckland because I think there was a sort of like a bomb scare and the weather wasn't good. And I was shivering. I thought, oh my goodness, I'll never hear the end of this from Margarita O'Reilly not turning up, apart from the Dane herself, who said, you know, you should have come earlier. And then in walked the fabulous Carla, and I thought, you know, it's going to, the planes, the heavens will calm down, and the planes did, and we did take off. So, Carla, thank you. I think your prayers were answered, because certainly mine weren't, but it was good to see you, and it was lovely to see all these other people. Who else? Oh, there's Dr. Nicolette Sheridan, the new chair of nursing for Massey, and also my friend Jacqueline Schmidt. These are all health people, by the way. Yeah. And there's the lovely Irish Water at the back, you know, from Tangata Fika. Who else can you see?
I understand that the Cook Islands High Commissioner to New Zealand, Her Excellency, is here, as well as representatives of the French Embassy, Stefan and James.
Oh, yes.
Where are you sitting tonight? Oh, yeah. Very much. And I have to also acknowledge our wonderful, wonderful team. I can see Mary Ama and who's over there? Can I see Tilke? Tiana. My eyesight's going. I think I can see Tuara Tini and Jacinda. You guys are now taking over Government House, is that I understand? Oh, yeah.
In just a minute, there's Aupito. I feel my Aupito. My law soifua, Aupito. You're trying to sneak in then, didn't you? And I saw you. My Lord, it was so wonderful to see you, Aupito. Yes.
Well, since it is, we've got 5 more minutes to go. It is New Way in Language Week. So I was going off on a little branch there when you cut off my tree. Fui maona.
Oh, sorry.
So can I ask Vela Manosote and Licky Burke to come to the stage? Yes.
Yes.
Because, you know, we need to, this is a very small New Zealand population, so thank you. Are you coming to the stage? Oh, there you are, thank you. Thank you, Vela. Woo! Thank you. Any other proud New Zealanders in the house? Do we have another? Oh, yes. Tingy.
Where's Tingy? Tingy. You're hiding, Tingy. I can see the white hair.
We can see you, Tingy. We can see you.
And your beard lets you off. Come on. Up you come. Tingy, okay. Come on.
We were thinking, because, you know, I only know a couple of words in Nguyen. The whakalofalahiatu ki motoloosi in Takihi. And whakawelahi koikia, monuine po, and vaea. That's the Tuvaluan village taking over Nguyen.
Here's Tingy. Here's Tingy.
Tingy, okay then. So can you words, but good New Zealand words that I could say to the minister, you know, and I could say to Jacinda. Okay.
Then you're chatting.
We're live streaming as well.
Okay, so yeah, for Olahi, Tarafa, thank you for the award. No, for Olahi, what do you want me to say? You said for Olahi, too low. Oi, longer than the Kaiha Tolga Kai Haga Maho, she don't you wear her eight Kai Mua, eight Kai to Kato for a Mua Haga Bay, the New Way Han. You lot of Tolga the money, or none of the Lalo Langi at the Tolga Maho. How to a New Way? New Way is number one. You know why, Marama? Because it will never sink.
Oh,
yeah. That's right, because it's on the highest atoll in the world. To low for our lahi, to low yakoi matingi, the hako mutalau is the number one village. So, where am I getting my awards?
Ladies and gentlemen, the literary prize for New Wind Language is.
I just want to say, and that's my cue to go off, right? But thank you so much for supporting Pacific Arts and supporting all the artists. So many artists did not get any award. Hey, we will apply next year. That's just the way to go. You know that, Carmel. You know, Sua, our community, everybody here. I know the world is watching, but thank you so much. Whakawela mahaki. Everybody's a winner.
But
only 6 people got away with some money, so don't you laugh at me. Thank you. I play for.
I ask a master artist, Tingi Lau, as well, to come.
Thank you. Whakalofalai atu ki tau tōlōs. Whakawelahi he mga ho nei koe tuku mai ki a niwe ke whakakisa atu e fulu fulu ala mwe toa Thank you very much. Representing all the Pacific here, the lofa lava ma loi lele ki ora na buluva naka namaste konnichiwa.
Okay. There might be the bell coming up very soon because I don't want to put you off, but I would love to hear Niuean language and Niuean song. Nuku tutaha. Is that the real Niuean word? If you can come here, Licky, and serenade me like I was single before. Okay, Licky.
Sure. Thank you for putting me on the spot. I'm not an opera singer, but I'll try my best. Maybe you guys can sing with me if you repeat after me. This is a simple Niuean chant about the tuaki and the taketake, which are two birds in Niue that are navigating birds that we use for navigation. And this chant talks about them flying around in the air and landing on the back of the whale. So I think it'll be a nice song chant to learn tonight. So everyone just repeat after me if that's all right. And manuina e wha hitapu. Happy Niue Language Week to you all. To you all? Yeah. Can everyone hear me? Okay, cool. Awesome. So repeat after me. Tuaki, tuaki, tolufa.
Tuaki, tuaki.
Take, take. Lele, ketu, ketu, ketu. Lele, ketu, ketu, ketu. Tafua. Thank you. Paspasi mai. Happy Language Week to you.
Thank you. Come on, let's give him another big hand. You look just impromptu stuff. Do you know, I just heard the first bell.
We've got 3 more minutes. Anyone else got another song? That was too short, Licky. Okay. What else happened for you this week?
Well, you know, I can't bring myself to say this because it's too embarrassing.
Oh, no, do.
Well, I nearly hanged myself with this bloody life for days. I came off the cab and the Bloomsbury caught me and I went... And the nice driver at the back, he says, watch out for my door of my cab. And I said, who gives a damn about your door? Let me hang out on the side. There's the second bell.
Oh wait, that bell there. See, the minister here, she'll recognise that bell. Can you hear it?
Yes.
Is that like a... How would we know if it is actually a fire? No? Alpito says that's not a fire.
That's not.
So if it is a fire and he's saying it's not okay. A fire, we'll blame Alpito.
So Steve, here it is.
Steve! Press play. Okay.
Every once in a while, but usually every Oscar season, a movie comes along that's like no other, except for all the other movies that are just like it. Then somebody discovers them. Then they skyrocket to fame, or it happens slowly, but nonetheless, overnight. Until jealousy, infighting, and egos tear them apart. And with superstardom comes addiction. It's basically a VH1 behind music, but with a $100 million budget, all you gotta do is dream. Or recycle an old script and add glitter.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Crystal Room is proud to present the club debut of America's newest recording stars, The Dreams.
Every man has his own special dream, and your dream is just about to come true. Life's not as bad as it may seem if you open your eyes to what's in front of you.
No. see the light. Girls always love you and they'll be true. You can go to know the make a love to you. Not the dream that you had before, and the dream that will give you more and more. You're dreaming, girls, boy, it will make you happy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're dreaming, girls, boy, we'll always care. Yeah.
How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Buckwheat in the green and Victoria in the yellow and Chanel in the purple.
Okay.
We need to invite the wonderful Karen Rangi, the Deputy Chair, Vice Chancellor for our next award. Now, Marama, you will not believe this, because I don't believe this. This is just works out just perfectly for me, because I'm going to introduce the winner of the award. And it's this is absolutely gospel truth. She wrote a play some years ago called Powder Room, and she conned me because I thought she wanted me to write. And what it was to call me to play a drag queen. Now, can you imagine this butch thing?
No,
I told you. Our next award winner is originally from Christchurch and has worked in the creative industry in New Zealand, Oceania, and globally for 3 decades in film, music, festivals, and major events, all the way from the South Island and the Cook Islands. The winner of the Special Recognition Award for 2019 is my friend, the beautiful Glenda Tuaine. They believe that you did, but
it is true. It is true, and he was the most gorgeous, sumptuous drag queen out there. He was absolutely beautiful, and I dance, roll around on the floor, act out all sorts of things. So he could challenge Buckwheat any day, just saying. Yeah. Yeah, okay, done. Later on, eh? Meitaki mata, meitaki korereka tu rakahanga. For that beautiful tūra. Kia ora ana, Honester, Associate Minister. Just combine them together. Yeah, that's a new word. For culture and heritage and the arts in Aotearoa, Carmel Cipollone. Kia ora ana, Creative New Zealand board members. Kia ora ana, Damoni Laban, who I saw in Samoa at the airport a couple of days ago. And especially kia ora ana to our Vainitoa, Karen Rangi, who we're very proud of. I'd like to also acknowledge the High Commissioner Liz Wright Kōtika, who is here as well, another incredible Vainetoa. Kia ora ana to the Vainetoa e Tānetoa of Moana Nui Akiwa. I proudly stand here as a descendant of Tamatoa Ariki of Araura Inua, Aitutaki. My grandparents, Te Nirau and Te Waia Nuanua, had two sons. My grandfather, Tuinikara Te Nirau Matoa, was the first man to leave Aitutaki for World War I and fought proudly in Gallipoli. My father, Morris Jackie Rangi Tuaine, married my mum, a papa a Pākehā, a woman Julie Kennedy, and he was a Vietnam vet, and I am their daughter. I am the definition of fruit salad. I'm the changing face, and the constantly changing face of the Pacifica, and I'm really proud to be standing here in front of you today. I'm the different shades of brown, as I put it. Accepting this award gives me the chance to thank a community of mentors, partners, colleagues, critics, challengers, creative people who cared about how important the arts and creative industries is to me and to them. Because of them, because of you, my career has been full of being able to develop, create and build arts projects that are varied and that support and grow Te Pasifika. The creative industries is the new taro plantation. It's the fertile soil that builds careers and economy for the current and future generations and allows and provides access for the Pacific to issues good and bad. And I'm proud to be a part of that. Very honoured tonight to be a farmer in the plantation. But I can't do what I do without the great people around me, and tonight I also honour my husband, Mo Newport, who's here with me tonight. And it's pretty special for us because it's our 21st wedding anniversary today. So thank you for the party, Carmel. I really appreciate it. Mo has supported me in all the ideas that I've had, and I know at times he's thinking, what are we doing now, Glenda? But he's a man that has supported me and not hindered me. He has always been there for me, and he's a technical creative superhero. I honour my daughter Ruby, who represents the future to me, the new vaka of creative, and she gives me new perspective and shows me what's happening, because half of the time I can't figure out how to get it on YouTube, and she sort of knows how to do it. And tonight, more importantly, I celebrate all of you, to the recipients and to all of the people in this audience. This room is what it represents to me about growth, and it represents about the new futures and the changes that are coming. Me take atu paka and ki manoia.
Well, there we go.
I'd like now to ask to come to the stage to present our next award, Wayne Marriott. Okay, our next award honours artistic innovation. Our next winner is an outstanding director and actor from South Auckland whose work has been performed in New Zealand, Oceania and the world. Most recently, she directed a groundbreaking Pasifika opera work starring Solomio and the all-women show Wild Dogs Under My Skirt by Tusiata Avia and produced by FCC. And that is now heading to New York in a couple of months. Very exciting. So the winner of the Contemporary Pacific Artist Award 2019 is the amazing Annabella Bolataibau.
I'm a tad short, aren't I? Let's just bring that down here a bit. Hello. First up, I want to acknowledge Aotearoa. And I'd like to acknowledge the tangata whenua of this land, and mainly New Zealand, because it's adopted me, a girl from Samoa. I was born in, well, not bred there, but I was definitely born there. And New Zealand has given me so many opportunities, such as this. Forgive me, because I am going to, there are so many things that I would like to say, And I don't want to miss this opportunity to be able to say it and also to thank everybody that has helped me along in my journey, because I'm not here alone. There are many unsung heroes that have guided, that have shifted, that have loved, have succeeded with me, failed with me, picked me up off the floor, and just continued on having my back. And as I look out tonight, you are that family, and there are many of you also that are not here. So I would like to acknowledge every single one of you. Collaboration. Collaboration has been a large part of my work. Collaboration, methodology, and how to bring work the truth. I am an artist who strives for truth. That is important to me because I understand my place, the majority. So I must stand vigorously in my art form and in my voice to tell the truth with love and always with respect. To all my unsung heroes that are not here with me, I would like to say a big fuck mano. Yes, I am accepting this award. Thank you for Creative New Zealand. Thank you very much to the beautiful people that thought of me, that recommended me, that support me, that sees this girl from Samoa, you know, worthy. To be really honest, I was quite awkward when I found out about the award. I feel awkward in the space because for so long you just work and work and work and work and work. This thing here, this recognition, I'm finding my place within it and really accepting it. So even as I stand here, I'm awkward because of accepting these things that I'm not quite used to, because I'm used to serving. It's a big thing for me, is service to my community and mainly to my people and to especially the women. The women. I would like to give a huge thank you to the women. But they are always people. But behind me, there are many, 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 many. Yeah, but I'm not wholly responsible, because with me always comes a team, not just myself, but also with my family and my ancestors. All of those people tonight, I really want to bring forth into the space and present them and acknowledge them wholeheartedly. Just to finish off, I'd like to thank my parents, Bulenga and Sitina Polaseivao. They came here with my brother and myself for a better life that was promised. And although my parents are not here with me tonight, and here I am standing at Parliament Building, once again going back to that girl from the plane, snotty nose, you know, who only knew two English words. That was please and thank you. What's your name? Thank you. Where would you like to go, please? I swear, that was really me. But I really hope that as I stand here tonight, that I have fulfilled that dream for them, because I am that product. I'm a product of the kid from the factory floor. I'm a product of that kid that does 2-3 jobs, and I do wish and hope that, you know, because in our way we don't really say these things, but I do hope that somehow they're proud that I am standing here representing them and my Bulakabau family. So to my family, to Vela, you know, from Kilakokonut Crew days, for teaching us how to go slog out in guerrilla styles, for eating rice for like 5 years, who knows. But lucky we had something, sometimes it was air. But hey, here. From all of that to today, for everyone that has touched me in profound ways through their teachings, mentorship, I'm talking from everybody in the last 25 years of my existence here in the arts. I want to acknowledge you and I thank you. And this ward is not just me, it's everyone. We are all one. We are, I am part of your family in the telling of my story. So in the words of Sia Figal, I is we, always. Whaftei te le lava. Thank you.
Oh, Annabella, you made me cry. We love you. Congratulations, Annabella. Okay, now.
No, it's your next guest speaker. Key person behind the Creative New Zealand.
We'd like to invite to the stage the CEO of Creative New Zealand,
Stephen Wainwright.
Kia ora koutou. It's lovely to be here amongst the stars. And my job is very short. Like Annabella, I'm here to thank people because people that stand behind us make all the good things happen. And first of all, I'd like to thank our elders, Marama and Carl. And also to acknowledge that it takes a village to put on these awards. And if you've read our Pacific Arts Strategy, you would know, and if you know about Pacific, that one of the great attributes of the Pacific peoples of New Zealand is that they are so youthful. And as you've seen tonight, so very talented. So we have embraced, they have adorned our space in our office in Wellington, and they've made these awards possible, actually. So I would, from the depths of our hearts and Team Urale, I would like to acknowledge their contribution. From Whitiroa Performing Arts, we have our cultural hosts, Samoana, Livonia, Tahuaroa, and Jacob. From Massey, we have our creative students, Winona, Sorsafina, and Saina. And from Victoria University, Henry and Anthony. And for the first time this year, we've created Tamaiti Youth Interns who are part of the staff project. And they come from the 312 hub in Onehunga, a creative space led by youth. And I'd like to thank their genuinely, amazingly inspiring leaders, Amelia and Bobby, who are here tonight. And last but by no means least, I would like to thank our youth interns, Carly and Elijah, who are working here tonight, and we have a small koha to acknowledge their awesome contribution.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Wow. Oh, the next award is one of my favourite categories, I must admit. Oh, actually, I'd like to ask, first of all, the Minister of Pacific Peoples, the Honourable Aupito William Seo, to join me on the stage to present this very special award. Well, the Pacific Heritage Arts Award recognises outstanding contribution to heritage arts in New Zealand. This year's award is shared by two master artists who have exhibited in New Zealand and internationally, all the way from Kiribati and the Coromandel. The winners of the Pacific Heritage Arts Award 2019 are Kaitaita Watson and Louisa Humphrey. Woohoo! Oh, do you want to just stand for a photo? We have a quick photo.
Well, what the thing? Come, Nathan and Naudi.
Naudi,
yes, you see, both of us are from the islands of Kiribati. They're still there. We're still here. So, to the Minister and Creative Art New Zealand Board and members, staff, and Arts Council of New Zealand, and all these people here. And we say, Kona Maori again, that's our greeting in Kiribati. And I'm stuck for word. Normally I'm not, but tonight I am stuck. But we're very much honoured to be standing here receiving this award. And we love working with what we know. We love sharing, working together with other artists, hoping our little heart we have will be able to share with, especially with our younger generations that are moved away from Kiribati and are here. And that's the beauty of being together, sharing and hearing other artists is lovely. And we're very grateful for tonight. Thank you.
Kona Māori, as Gadeda was expressing, we're just overwhelmed and we're stuck for words. And as she says, we're normally very talkative ladies. But tonight, we're just overwhelmed, and we stand here receiving this award on behalf of all our Pacifica Heritage Arts people that are not here, but they all deserve this. We don't know how we got this, but we thank the nominations. And we thank Creative New Zealand for all the work and recognising the work that we do as contemporary artists to promote our Kiribati heritage and to nurture it for our future generation that have now made their home in New Zealand, Aotearoa. We're grateful and we're lost for words, and we honour you all, and we honour all our Pacific people. And we love you all. Thank you.
My love, after I tell you, love, I love you, my sister, Alpito William C.O. You know, we now come to our final report. Seems so fast, isn't it? And to be the presenter for our final award for the evening is somebody, of course, doesn't need any introduction except to say the fabulous, wonderful, gorgeous La Fionga Luma Vau, Dame Winnie Laban. Our final award for this evening goes to a pioneer of Pacific theatre, one of the first Pacifica to graduate from New Zealand Drama School. He wrote and performed the first solo show by a Pacific island in New Zealand in the 1980s. He was given us hilarious enjoyment as one of the laughing Samoans, and has served the Pacific art community for over 35 years. All the way from right here in Wellington, the winner of the Senior Pacific Artist Award
2019 is the absolutely stunning Iti Wati Iti.
Ile a valava mal fa lolet sa wai o te fa talo fa twai ma mal mun pa ia ua a fier nei a fia fi sunga minsta ai la sunga daim lo man vao. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to stand here before you. When you start out on this journey, you never think you are going to be of any significance, but you put one foot in front of the other and you continue to climb until you come to a milestone, you turn a corner, you look back and you look down on the world and you think, wow, we have come so far. And I say we because I am not here alone. The arts is about collaboration. Even a painter needs paint. A canvas. There are many people I want to thank. I want to thank the Arts Council. We in New Zealand, as Pacific Islanders, are leading the development of Pacific arts in the world. We've been to the world and they've said, what's in your water? So Creative New Zealand, when you give us support, it makes us stronger. When you turn us down, it makes us even stronger. There are many people I want to thank. I want to thank Teresia, who 5 years ago nominated me for this award. I want to thank Pele Walker for putting this nomination forward, who 7, 8 years ago, when she was chair of the Pacific Arts Committee, said to me, Ete, why are you not? And I said, because others need it more than I do. I want to thank my parents. They can't be here tonight. They live in Wellington. They were invited, but they are at a funeral. Am I upset about that? When I was a younger man, I might have been. But this is the legacy that my parents have taught me. Think of others first, Ete. Your award, good, but we have the world to serve. And they have taught me that. That is the legacy that they have taught me. Think of others before yourself. I want to thank everyone that's ever crossed my path. Those who have pushed me, thank you. Those who have hindered me, thank you too. You have made me stronger. I want to acknowledge my good friend, Tofinga Fipulea'i, because I thought I was helping Tofinga. He's actually taken me to another level. I want to thank my children because there are people that you only have so much time and you spend some of it away from your children. So Manaya, Teha, Moana, Sina, I love you and I thank you. To the hero of this story, my wife, Mele. I'm not sure how big that jackpot is now, the lotto jackpot. But I haven't bought a ticket because I had won when I met this woman. So I'm not going to take up any more of your time. Auntie, thank you. Karen, thank you. And everybody. Fafetai te lelava.
Malo fafetai lava rao fionga lo manuvao. Well, that is it. Except, of course, any Pacific Island function always ends with a chawalunga. And I'm going to ask the Fionga Lumanwa Winnie, the Fionga the Honourable Sepuloni to be up here, Susunga Karen Rangi to be up the front here, followed by the Minister Aupicho. He's and the Creative New Zealand, Nani Hila, you also coming up here as well. And to start off our chawalunga, can I ask all the recipients also to join? But let's start with our... Come on, let's give them a big hand to come up.
Yes. A round of applause for all of our winners tonight. Pati Umanga, Tyler Vayau, Samson Setu, Glenn Twaine, Annabella Polataibau, Kaitaita Watson and Louisa Humphrey and Ete Wati Ete. Pacific meal. I think there's ulupuaka and takihi and chocolate fondue. Actually, we're going to be here till 10:30 tonight, so make sure you rock it, okay? I want Parliament to know that we were here tonight.
Till 10:30.
Okay, and I'd just like to ask all the recipients, Arts Council and the Ministers and CEO as well to come to the stage for our official photographs. And I'd just like you guys to put your hands together as well for the woman behind this big production, polished performance, Makarita Urale, all the team, Erolia Ipopo, and all the team. Thank you also to our wonderful lighting and sound team as well. And have a wonderful night, everyone. Thank you for coming and celebrating our arts community. We love you guys. We're so very proud of you and all of the wonderful contribution you make to Aotearoa New Zealand.
Good night, everybody. Good night.
Thank you.